Right, guys. The next talker, next speaker, Rob Freeman, if anyone can. Rob can. From the Out of the Matrix show every Wednesday on Critical Mass Radio. Everybody knows Rob. Everybody chases Rob. If there's information there, Rob's got it. And he's going to basically do about a 2-hour talk on a lot more new information that he's got ready for you today. Please listen carefully. Also, while you're listening to Rob, there's a little email sheet going down. If you can put your email on there, please, and then you get updates from Freedom Northwest, etc. As they come. So, what I want to say is, personally, a big thank you to Rob, because he's been a major influence to Critical Mass Radio. There's a lot going on. He's being filmed at the moment as well for things coming up in the future. So, what I'll just say is, a massive, huge round of applause for Rob Freeman. Thank you.
Cheers, Paul, for that. Beat me up a bit there, didn't he? I don't think I'm that good, right? But yeah. So Paul himself did a great presentation and talk earlier. And Ceylon, I don't know if he's still in the room, but fantastic stuff. Ceylon's actually covered some of the stuff I was going to cover. So I'm frantically crossing stuff out I was going to tell you about. The deed of assignment and stuff like that. So I'm going to have to wing some of this, but we'll get some good info out anyway. Yeah, so I can't believe how many people have turned up, which is brilliant. I can't see through these. I've got some pinholes, you know, but I'm that lazy, I'm back to specs again. So, you've got no idea how excited I am to be here today. I thought, well, you might have, but I'm really, really excited. we've all been pushing this, but on the radio show that I do, I've been saying that this is, for me, I've been doing stuff now for about, forgive me if I don't address you on that side, I'll try my best. I've been doing stuff for about 5 years now, on my own mostly, and then I came across Get Our Debt Free, and I thought, wow, this is just incredible, this. And they were doing a similar thing to what I was already doing, but much better than I was actually doing myself. So everything that Ceylon's told you today is absolutely spot on. And so I was on my own for a while, and what I've noticed 5 years, 3 years, this last 2 years, more people are grouping together, and 2012, they shoved that on us, didn't they? They hammered us, it's the end of this, end of that. And we all knew that's the beginning, really. My best year so far, in my opinion, has been 2012. Because of people like yourselves, people in the groups, people to do with Critical Mass Radio. We're now joining together, and for me, this is what today's all about. It's about us. All of you should be really proud of yourselves for getting on for us. By the way, if anyone's offended by swearing, tough, because I do swear a lot. I can't express myself any other way. You should be really proud of yourself for getting off your fucking arses and getting down here today when you could be doing something else, like the 99% who are half asleep, you know what I mean, still asleep rather. And what I want you to do today is swap email addresses, stay in touch with each other, because what happens is, we have these talks, everyone's all energetic and everyone feels good, and for 2 or 3 weeks we're all buzzing, and then we lose contact again, don't we? And today's about staying in touch. You can do it through the radio stations, through the various websites, like I said, these Get Out of Debt Free, I don't mind doing that with my hands. These Get Our Debt Free and stuff like that. So let's try and stay networked and linked. Okay, so that's what today's all about. And also, as Rob B mentioned, he's been speaking a bit on his radio show. Today's about motivating and inspiring. We can do this. I think we've got a small window of opportunity, and it's now. This is it for us. If we don't forget about them that are asleep, they'll come across when they come across. Unfortunately, we are all one family, they're our brothers and sisters, but we've got to kind of leave them behind a little bit now. We can't wait for these people. We can do this. If we act now, I think, I don't know exactly, I don't know the time, but I think we've got 18 months tops. And if we don't take this chance now, I think we've fucked it, to be honest. Now that might seem pessimistic, and it's not meant to be. We've been given this chance, I really think we came here for this chance. We've got this small window now, and that's what we want to do it now. And the thing is, it looks daunting. There's all the horrible shite that's going off, the chemtrails, like Ceylon said, the fluoride, the horrible, horrible wars and stuff, and the debt stuff, and it all looks like a fucking mountain, doesn't it? And it's not. And all we've got to do is just say one word, and it's 2 letters, and it's no. In my case, it's no, fuck off. And that's it. If you say no, you're not consenting. If you keep quiet, you're consenting. It's up to us. Everything they've done, I don't know, I call them a criminal class, I'll address you as well. It's the criminal class, whatever you want to call. I don't call them the elite, because they're not elite, they're fucking lower than us. Everything they've done so far, there's got to be some sort of rules to this engagement, because we've still got free will by about that much. This is what I mean, 18 months goes by, that free will's gone in my opinion. Another 4,218 pieces of legislation from fucking fatties in Brussels have shoved it through in 2012. Nobody's noticed that's another 400,000 pieces of legislation further taking our freedoms and rights away. So what I'm saying is they're shoving legislation through like mad. April the 1st, all the judiciary was changed. Again, not for our behalf. Legal aid's getting more and more difficult to get. People on benefits are suffering. People with disabilities can't get their benefit entitlement. Pensions are long disappearing, as we know. So what I'm saying is the squeeze is on for us. And the reason it's on for us is because we're getting close. We're getting very, very close and getting results. So that's what today for me is all about. Like I said, I've been doing stuff for 5 years or so. The only thing left that I've got left to pay personally is my mortgage, and that's it. I don't pay anything. And like I said, get out of debt free, we're doing a very, very similar thing to me, but theirs much better than mine. I just did the three-letter principle. Anyone placing a demand on me, I'm steaming up here. Anyone placing a demand on me, usually financial, ask for three things, and then don't forget, I think altogether I owed a massive amount. I think I owed about 17 grand out in bits and bobs. Had to pack working, start looking after my kids full time. So not a massive debt, but a big enough debt to have an headache. And I got rid of it really, really quickly. And I realised that each debt, as Salon quite rightly said, every one of mine I got rid of within 24 days. Gone, done. And all I ask for is a copy of the original contracts, a life signed bill with a life signature. All they send you is statements, credit card, bank loan, excuse me, mortgage, although we'll leave mortgages for in a bit. It's a statement, they don't send you a bill, do they? If I were to do some work for you and you said, oh, how much do I owe? And I said, oh, grand. And you said, well, send me a bill. I won't send you a statement, would I send you a bill? Wouldn't I sign it, wouldn't I? To make sure somebody's not knocked it up on the computer. So, copy the original contracts, not even the original one, just a copy of the original contracts, which they've never got, because all they've got is an agreement. Agreement's only ever signed by one party. It's called an unenforceable unilateral agreement, means absolutely shy. If I say I agree to meet with pub tonight and I don't turn up, you can't take me to court, can you? It's just an agreement, isn't it? But if we sign a contract, a bilateral, buyers in bicycle two, we both sign, then it becomes a lawfully binding contract. And that's what they've never got in place. So, again, get out of debt free, cover this. So, every talk I've done, I must have done 15 talks now. And every single time I do, I say get on to get out of debt free. Because it's literally saving people's lives. It's absolutely brilliant. And it covers it more extensively. Do you want to ask a question?
Can I just ask a very quick question? You know when they send you a copy of your agreement, it has a computer generated signature. Does that not count then? You know, there's your signature and then there's usually...
Yeah, well, they've passed legislation to say a photocopied signature does count.
Right.
An electronic signature. But what I'm saying is, somebody could have knocked that up on a computer, couldn't they?
Yeah.
Okay, so you want it's called a live sign, but we call it a wet signature.
Yeah.
So it's a live signature. Whoever puts pen to paper is instantly liable. That's why they don't do it. That's why they work for limited liability corporations. They limit their liability. Whoever signs that, we sign it, don't we? We're not frightened. We get, and I know someone covered the inks, which I'm going to do as well. That's interesting stuff, the colour of the ink. But we sign it, don't we? And we sign it, why? Because we're not hiding. They're hiding. So they might say an electronic one is legal. I've got to tell you, I live as unlegal as anybody I know possible. Now notice I didn't say illegal, unlegal. Big difference. Phew, that's right on here. I just take my jacket off for 2 seconds. Paul told me to take that off, no? Yeah, I don't live illegally because that's using their system. What I've realised is that I've bypassed the legal system. The legal system is developed for one reason, that's for the criminals to hide behind and extract every bit of wealth off us and erode every single freedom and rights that we think we're entitled to. That's the idea behind the legal system. So if you're using the term illegal, you're down their path. So what I decided to do was to live as unlegal as possible. So that's the legal system. I live by common law of the land. one law, I've said it many times, you might be getting bored of it, but if you don't cause harm, do not cause harm to another living soul. That's it. What else is there to know? You know whether you're doing something wrong to someone, don't you? Don't cause harm. That includes injury, that includes fraudulent contracts, whatever. Don't cause harm to another living soul. That's it, that's all you've got to live by. So what I do is I live by that. And but that's the legal system. And I just sidestep it. They ignore us, I ignore them. I sidestep their legal. All the shite that they send, to me, is absolutely irrelevant. The legal system is aimed at our legal person, our legal name, Mr. Rob Freeman, or Rob Freeman in capitals. So what I do is bring it back to the human being. So I ask for a copy of the original contract. There isn't one in place. A life-signed bill. Don't send me a statement. Imagine me going to a restaurant, waiting to have a statement. You're fucking on about, aren't you? You want a bill, don't you? Sign. So, copy of the original contracts, a life-signed bill, and if it's a loan or a credit card or a mortgage, you ask for, and that's the only three things that I've asked for, is a copy of, say it's a £5,000 bank loan. I know I've covered this a lot, but there's a lot of new faces, so say it's a £5,000 bank loan. I ask for a copy of the accounting that shows that £5,000 was transferred from their account into my account. Now, what I failed to tell you is, keep picking over from here, there's a lumpy copy. I'm being bugged, I think, so. What I failed to tell you is, I never argue with them, I never fall out with them, because what they want is, this legal system, is to get us into conflict. As soon as they get us into conflict, it's in court. They say it's £5,000, if I say I don't, I owe you £3,000, I'm going to address you as well. If I say I owe you £3,000, not five, conflict, bunk court. If I say, fuck off, I'm not paying you, conflict, we're in court. So all I do is, and I know get out of debt free, when I finally got it, I thought, wow, some other weirdo, same as me. I just say, what do I say? I've got all blank now, I've got a little bit of brain fart going off
it.
Right.
Accept it.
Oh, sorry, yeah, brilliant. Yeah, I accept everything, thanks a lot, guys. I accept everything they throw at me, never ever caught, never argue, never cause conflict. Okay, I may owe you £5,000, I can't remember, I can't fucking remember what I did yesterday. So I'll tell you what, show me a bit of proof that I owe it. Show me proof that I have a lawful financial obligation to you, and I'll go to the bank now, and I'll go and pay it. I won't, because I'm fucking skint like, well, they don't know that. So, prove that I owe it you, and I'll go and pay it. So, where's the conflict in that? Where's the reason to go to court? There isn't, is there? So what proves it? A copy of the original contracts. Send me a proper bill so I know it's you that's sending it me, not some idiot up street on his computer. And if it's a loan, show me a copy of accounting. They can't show you that £5,000 transferred from their account to yours because, as Salon was saying earlier, they never lent you anything if it's a bank loan or a credit card or a mortgage. We create the funds with our signature. So they never had it in their account in the first place. So like I say, give them a bit of time. 10 days, I usually give them 14 days first time. Follow it up, give them another 10 days. You don't have to, like Salon says, you can do it 3 days, but I try and be a little bit honourable. 14 days, 10 days, time's up, fuck off. Three letters, stunning, for me it's done in 24 days. But what I also do is on the second letter, when I'm giving them the extra time, trying to be honourable, I also chuck in now a fee for my services. And the trick for me is, I always get them to owe me more money than what they're claiming I owe them. Does that even sound feasible? For instance, council tax people, they bill me for £3,500. I've only ever had one bailiff come to the door, and like Salon says, quite rightly, I've got denial of access. He walked up me, General. I said, have you seen notice? He went, yeah, I didn't understand it. I went, well, fucking go back and read it again. And he read it, and he come back like that. He goes, do you understand it now? He goes, not really. He goes, does it mean that if I don't get off your property? This is a bailiff for council tax. He says, does it mean if I don't get off your property, I owe you £5,000? I went, yeah, mate. He went, oh. That's it, went. So 100% what Salon says, it does work. Oh, I've lost me then now. Where would I? Kath? Where would I? Has anybody got any idea where I am? Oh. Italian bloke called in, he says, do you want some free beer? I went, yeah, he went, get on there and talk bollocks for 2 hours. So, I don't even know what I'm talking about. Anyway, where were I going with that? Anybody got? Yeah?
No, acceptance.
Condition,
yes, sir.
Oh, yeah, brilliant, thank you very much. So, yeah, I accept everything, and then because it's all right, smile, I'm just taking a piss out of you there. I accept everything, they can't take me to court, can they? Oh, that were it. Council tax people billed me for £3,500. Sent the letters, sent the ski schedule, What's Steve doing? So, it's not Steve anymore.
I was grabbing a drink.
I think you've had enough.
So I sent him a ski for, I sent him that piece of paper on my second letter. And because they can't do anything or give me what I want, fee schedule, they have accepted it. So now, council tax people, I wasn't even going to start with this. Council tax people have billed me for £3,500. Oh, also, on the fee schedule, I put £50 a day late payment charges. They've accepted it because they're not arguing about it. They've accepted it. £50 a day, interest, I lobbed a lot on it. So they billed me for £3,500. I keep saying I'm going to turn this way. And I've now billed them. In fact, all they do now is every year in March, it's an automatic bill that they just generate and send out. And straight away, it's only a bill. I've just billed them for £17,000. Which is good, isn't it? So they won't ever take me, and I do this for everything, but they won't ever take me to court because a judge is an accountant, that's why you're held accountable in court. He's just a bookkeeper, that's what fucking it's like. Besides with them. Somebody says something?
That's why they pay the support services, because it's a programme on the letter when it says corporate and support services is a Microsoft programme, what they have to pay at the council as a corporate company. They have to pay Microsoft £100,000 every month.
Is that right?
Yeah,
lovely.
Support services.
Nice information on that. Yeah. Cheers. Cheers
it's
for that.
For Bill Gates for his so-called authenticity for goodness.
Nice one. Yeah, so all a judge will ever do is he holds accounts, and what they do, we call it a valid bill, it's not from the council. Valid bill from the council, Rob Freeman holds £3,500. Ooh, but an equally valid bill from Rob Freeman, £17,000. All they could ever do, the council, is write me the cheque out for the difference and set it off. So that's why they'll never take me to court. I wish they would. What's £3,500 off 17? It's over 12 grand nearly, isn't it? But you see what I mean? I've not argued ever, I've not caused a dispute, I've not caused a conflict, and I've done it with everything, so I've got rid of every single financial demand placed on me. This is not how I was going to start at all, so I'll just turn over.
Can I ask, you know about that council, the tax letters and all that, you know when you've received them, do you get Manchester or not?
No, I'm from Sheffield, sorry.
Right, well, we get Stockport Council Services,
yeah.
And it says, Corporate Support Services, P.O. Box.
Okay.
And then it says a phone number what's non-existent, and the www.contact.com.at is non-existent.
Well, I
on the letter it says
I have
changed. Does your letter state that I have changed your council tax?
No. To be honest, I only use council tax as an example.
Yeah,
it's not something I really want to cover. I don't know. Mine don't. It's just a standard bill because I only get one a year and it goes back. And I send the original back.
Because I is a fraud letter.
Okay, I think Rob B might be covering council tax. I just use it as an example. I could have picked any bill really. But I didn't really want to cover that. But I can chat to you after.
Yeah,
that's all right.
I
yeah.
All right. Same letter, this map, this
since now, mine's just a normal bill that gets sent every year by Sheffield Council.
But
it goes
not
by.
Say I have changed.
No. Well, this last one did.
It
just says Sheffield City Council, blah 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 blah. I don't really read them now. I don't bother reading them.
Stockport at the base, people. If they say that letter, then every other council will use that letter. So
okay. Well, hold that thought, because I'm not really talking about council tax. But nice one for info. I'll have a chat with you after. You know, that's going to throw me even more now, because I don't even know where I am now. So yeah, any bill like that's what I do. So like I said, I've got rid of every financial demand there is, and I've got rid of it pretty quick and all. It must be 5 years ago now, the early Freeman stuff, and it's the power of the contracts. Everything is contract, everything comes down to contracts. All law, when you get took to magistrates court or county court or whatever, is commercial. That's it, it's all about money, that's why you get fined. So if all law is commercial, all courts are commercial, all law is commercial, well, all commerce is contracts. So contract makes the law. It's simple. It's very, very simple. No contract. I'm not saying this is the way to go. This is what I do. No contract, no obligation. And that's how I've lived. And it's worked every time. Lee, did you want to say something?
Even the High Court of Chancery is open 24/7 because it's accessing your public bonds. It's the only court that's open after.
Is it King's Bench or Queen's Lee?
You can turn it into.
Okay. Okay, nice one.
Is that the same as the King's Commons?
Is this something to do with Court of Record?
Sorry, just speak up, I can't hear you. But
is this something to do with Court of Record?
What, Chancery?
Yeah. Is that the same?
Go on, lead your answer.
Is Chancery the same as Court of Record in the U.S.?
Lee will have to answer you. Do you know? It's not. I don't know, to be honest. I don't know.
Don't they all fall under UCC?
It's called
the
Malavinci
anyway. All right, that's not...
The master. Whatever they do, the Malavinci.
Hold on, we're getting different, we're getting varying. We can't take it all in. Somebody on this side wants to say something.
Sorry.
Who is it?
Whatever it is, the causing is Malavinci anyway.
Malavinci, what's that?
We've not caused rape, death or theft.
Back to Armageddon, isn't
it? That's it, yeah. No, but that's what we go, that's what everybody should be saying. Now, we have not caused malamenti, so you cannot cause malaprohibiti.
Okay. We've not caused any harm, what did you want to say?
I was just saying I've shown you UCC, all them things have fallen under UCC.
Yeah, everything falls under UCC, it's the law of the sea, it's commerce, isn't it? But they say... Well, they say Britain don't fall under it. This is how they word the way out of it. But to be honest...
It's on the public record that it's been closed.
Okay, so basically, common law, law of the land, it's common sense. Don't cause anybody any harm. That's it. If you don't cause anybody any harm, who are you ever accountable for? So that's the idea. I question every single perceived power of authority. Government are supposed to work on our behalf. They are public servants. They are. We've entrusted them, and they've abused our trust. So based on that, I question every single... every single perceived department of authority, I challenge authority and I question every single letter, and that's what we can do now. We can all send emails, make a phone call, we can all write a letter, it's nothing. This is what I want us all to do, this is what today's about. I've been now, did somebody want to ask a question?
Yeah, on the Queen's speech this year, she actually said, we are a maritime country.
Wow. That's come from Lizard Breath herself. Wow. She didn't shapeshift at the same time, did she? So that's a nice girl to talk about. So that shows you, doesn't it? Yeah, it's Admiralty Maritime Law. It's the law of the sea. We're being judged instead of the law of the land, as you probably all know. The law of the sea. It's not really the law of the sea. It's the law of the Holy Sea.
Yeah, correct.
It's a Roman Vatican. The Roman Vatican. What is it?
No, Vatican,
I'm tongue twisted today.
It's the Vatican, but like I speak to Lee earlier on, a lot of that's been changed, but Lee will probably put you up on that. But a lot of that's changing at the moment. But obviously, I just want you to continue what you're doing. They're claiming it's that, but unfortunately, there's other things that have gone on, so they're not functioning in the way that it was functioning for. But Lee will pull you in on a bit on that.
Alex, over to you, Lee. Did you want to say something? Well, I just made a right choice myself.
And can everybody keep the questions until after, so we can carry on?
I don't mind, actually. I normally do a talk where I've got a whiteboard and stuff, but I don't mind because I want us all to chuck something into it. It's a debate for me. It's not like the other stuff that the others are doing, which is fantastic. I don't mind because it's all part of what we're doing. I don't mind these. You can throw these questions at me today. This was going to be my last talk, and it's a different talk to what I'd normally do.
You can read them out if you want. It's good news.
Well, I'll let you read it out, Lee, in a bit.
All right.
Do you want to?
Yeah.
I know you don't. You're not averse to speak. Yeah, we'll do that in a bit.
Yeah, no worries.
Okay, I'm just losing my train of thought again here. But you can keep asking questions. It's brilliant. I don't mind that. Yeah. So as far as we know, it's Admiralty Maritime Law.
Yeah.
Maritime
Admiralty.
Yeah. Admiralty Maritime Law. The law of the sea. That's what we're being. You know, it's the law of money, commerce. Any word with MER, which is French for sea, basically. It's the law of the sea, and all it means is it's law of money and fucking pay, and that's it. So that's where I'm coming from. That's where I'm coming from. Back to common law of the land for me. I'm not causing anybody on any harm at all, so I'm not accountable to anybody, and that's how I've lived. Okay. I'll tell you what, I was going to start with this. Because Ceylon's done a lot of stuff I was going to do, I'll tell you how we've got into this state that we're in. Okay, that law of the sea thing, they can only ever take action on this legal, the person, the legal name. They can't take any action on us as a human being. That's what I meant when I said there are still some rules, there's a little bit of free will left, because they have to trick us into consent. Now that's, you can consent by silence. If you don't speak out, if I said, Del, you owe me 5 grand, and I keep on at him, and he never says anything, And chances are he fucking owes me £5,000, doesn't he? Because he's not saying anything, so he's consenting. Yeah.
It's not rebutted the claim.
Yeah.
The claim stands until it's rebutted.
Until it's rebutted. And so what they do is they very, very skillfully, they trick us into consent. Consent can be by action or by inaction. And so, I don't know why I made these notes, because I wasn't going to talk about this, but this is the reason. I don't normally read from notes, but I thought, well, this is quite interesting, this. The very first talk I ever did in Manchester last year, before I got into this law and money stuff 5 years ago, I've been studying stuff since a little kid in the 70s, and I studied how your mind works, and this is quite interesting, this. It's only 5 minutes. This is why we are in the state we are in now, and how clever these fuckers are. And that's why these people are still walking about, talking about Coronation Street and football and who shagged who. And it's down to this. Now, this is why I said I'm so proud of you all today. Because we're away from this. I don't like to say awakened, but we are. We're aware. We're aware now. And we've joined together and we can do something about it. This, I want to explain to you how it works, is absolutely incredible. The system they've got, the deception, it's almost sorcery, how they've tricked us. And through our apathy, we're consenting, we deserve all we've got, but not now, we don't, because today's where we start. So I'll give you a few quotes, and I don't know why I wrote this down. Okay, this is a quote from Dennis Healy, of all people. I did this on my very first talk in Manchester, some of this, and somebody asked me if I would repeat it, so I will. Okay, Dennis Healy, a former British politician, said, bear in mind the Boston shite that's just happened, he said, Dennis Healy said, world events do not occur by accident. They are made to happen, whether it is to do with national issues or commerce. And most of them are staged and managed by those that hold the purse strings. So that's Dennis Healy, says it all, doesn't it? Okay. The masses watch the news, get their information from mainstream media newspapers. They're just fucking gullible. I mean, I love them all, but they're knobheads, aren't they? You know, if you don't feel, I'm sorry, but if you don't feel something's wrong in here by now, you better check your pulse, not that how fast it is, whether you've fucking got one or not. Well, everybody knows there's something wrong now, don't they? Everybody knows the government's a bag of shit. So, Paul?
Just another major quote spot from Roosevelt as well, exactly what you're saying there. Nothing in politics is accidental. It happened that way.
Yeah.
Brilliant, Richie. I'll cross that fucking out there, shall I? Just repeat it again, Paul.
Roosevelt, nothing in politics is accidental. If it happened that way, be sure it was planned that way.
Yeah. Wow. I'm just going to cross that one out now, Paul. Thanks a lot, mate. Yeah, so another one. Okay, Fred, I'll run through this and then I'll get on to some stuff that I've been doing that we can use. This is just to show how manipulated we are. Fred Gates, he was a Rockefeller associate apparently, said, get this, people yield themselves with perfect docility to our moulding hands. Notice our moulding hands, he was part of it. Alan Watts, who wasn't part of their horrible shite system. Does anybody know Alan Watts, spiritual teacher? Yeah, fantastic, yeah. Alan Watts said, get this, we seldom realise that our most primitive thoughts and emotions are not actually our own. We think in terms of language and images, which we did not invent, but which were given to us by society. We copy emotional reactions from our parents. Get this, society is our extended mind and body. Very deep sentence, that one sentence is very deep. The shite that's happening out there, we have got some sort of responsibility because it's the shite that's happening in the air. Not to us now, but to the masses. Something internal is happening inside the human psyche that is then projected out there. So by changing us, I know a lot into spiritual stuff think he's talking bollocks now. You look red cool when I'm sunglasses on, by the way. That's super cool. I like it.
So I can see you.
Looks good, that. What was I saying? I get distracted really easy. You know, I did a talk once and there was a chandelier that was sparked. I loved it. I wanted to take it home with me, so I get really distracted. Yeah, so something internal to the collective, to the masses, is happening in there that's then projecting out there. So you've got to... Your whole perception of how you view things is what's going to change it out there, as well as taking physical steps. I don't mean just sitting in a bedroom chanting and sending positive vibes out. That's long time, that's gone, and today's all about action. But by changing ourselves, our perception of things, it'll change out there. So what do I mean by changing ourselves? By realising that we're the fucking power, not them.
Yeah, definitely.
We've given away control of the power, but we are the fucking power, not them. Government work for us. They're all public service, they work for us. It's up to us. And this is what today's going to be about. As far as I'm concerned, and this is what we can do. I've done it. Sterling work, I'll get to you in a minute. Sterling work from Ceylon, get out of debt free. Everybody get on that side. Whether you've got debts or not, if you've got no debts, you might have soon, in fact you will have soon, because the squeeze is on to push their agenda in. Get on, get out of debt free. Our manager, Paul Giovanni, get on Critical Mass Radio. If you've not heard the shows, get on it, join the chat room. And Robbie, another host on our radio station, just unbelievable work, and he's talking next. In fact, probably the five most active people in this country, and there's four of us here today, I would say our manager, Paul Giovanni, for not just setting the station up, but continuing it. We don't get a lot of money, and he continues it, and he networks us all, and keeps us all together. Five most active people in this country, in my opinion. Paul Giovanni. Paul Giovanni, still on from Get Out of Debt Free, an absolute fucking saint. Rob B. Simon Spaniard, who I've only met once and he's not here today, and myself. I think five of us are really pushing it out there.
Yep.
Yeah. Well, we're gonna. This is what today's all about. Okay, so I'll just finish this off now because it sounds like a lot of box, doesn't it? For anybody's interested in how your mind works and stuff, and who are the master manipulators, check out. I know you've heard of him, Edward Bernays. He's the father of public relations. Anybody interested in film? I did a write-up on this for a website. Have a look at Sergei Eisenstein, film, television and film. He was there 100 years ago. He created a system of film editing in Russia. He worked for, I think, Lenin and Trotsky, I can't remember, but 100 years ago or so, when cinema first came out, he worked for those people pushing the communist stuff in Russia, and he developed a system called a montage of fast editing. Really interesting stuff it is. You watch today's modern films, action films, today's modern rock and pop videos, it's cut, cut, slice, slice, isn't it? Before you've got a chance to focus on one scene, the other one's hit you. You've noticed that and others have hit you, and that's what he developed 100 years ago. So check out Sergei Eisenstein, interesting stuff. Anybody still watching telly now, what are you doing? Kick it out, throw it through the fucking window. It's a load of bollocks. Anybody reading the mainstream paper, unless it's to have a laugh, it's alright if you want to burn something, innit? Or, you know, I'll smoke a joint with me inside, do some paper or something. Okay, so I'll just finish this off. Okay, get this. Manly P. Hall. I heard a who in the audience
there.
Yeah,
that's just me.
Yeah, Manly P. Hall, the initiate Freemason, philosopher and occultist, said, get this. So this is all proving their agenda and how they've done it to us. I will get back to you, buddy, in a sec, whoever wants a question. Just give us 2 seconds. Okay, Manly P. Hall said, it is impossible to chain man merely by enslaving his body. The mind also must be held. And to accomplish this, fear is the accepted weapon. Abso-fucking-lovely. Is that even a word? The common man must fear life, fear death, fear God, fear the devil, and most of all, fear the overlords, the keeper of his destiny. It sums it up, doesn't it? That's the agenda they're working to. Yes. Fucking evil people.
I think
we fear ourselves. Yeah. Secondly, I can't
hear you. Yeah, definitely agree with that.
Secondly, I can't hear you.
I think we fear ourselves.
Yes.
That's what I'm saying about what's happening out there. The only fear that is really, I don't know, applicable is the fear that you create inside yourself. Well said, Lee. And that's what's projected out.
But it's a learned behaviour.
Say again?
It's a learned behaviour.
It is, but what is it to fear? I come from more of a spiritual background. A lot of people laugh at me.
It's
sorry,
programmed, it's a learned behaviour.
Okay, well, what is it to fear? Somebody name me something to fear. Name a fear.
Death.
Pardon?
Fear.
Who said death? Put your hand up if you said death. What are you scared of? What did he say? What are you scared of? It's not the death, is it? You're not actually scared of the death, you're either scared that there's nothing at the end of it, like blackness. Well, if there was, what's going to be scared of? It's blackness, it doesn't matter, does it?
At the end of what I've got now.
Or you, okay, or you may be scared of it's a horrible place where you go to, yeah? Identify who you are. Identify who you are. It's all turned a bit spiritual and bollocks, isn't it?
There is no such thing as death.
That's correct.
We dream and live, but the imaginations of ourselves.
Fantastic. Correct. Long live Bill Higgs. I'll tell you now, there's nothing to be scared of. Nothing to be scared of, has it come out of Italian? There's nothing to be scared of. That's what the granddad used to say just before he hit me across. Hey, there's nothing to be scared of, Roberto. What's the name? There's nothing to be scared of. I'm talking bollocks, aren't I, Ralph? Cancel that film. There's not to be scared of. Scared of. Because what is it? Death, what is energy? This is what I mean, like spiritual walks. Energy can only get transferred, it can't get destroyed. It gets transferred to another place, so what are we scared of? You're not going to starve to death. In fact, if anybody wants a website, there's millions of people all over the world now that don't eat anything. They don't even drink water. Food is toxic, you don't even have to eat. Breatharians and stuff. Okay, so what are we scared of? Okay, last thing that we may be scared of is losing our possessions, yeah? Well, we don't fucking possess them, do we? We can't get inside them. They actually are helping to enslave us. So what are we actually scared of? There's nothing. There's a great song written by Chris Christopherson, nice one. I like country music. I'm sorry, I'm getting old. Oh, by the way, I'm trying to grow a ponytail. Look at fucking state of that. I'm trying to be like Ceylon and Spaniard. So, but they're miles in front of me. So there's a I like country music. There's a song by Chris Christopherson, quite old now, and it was made famous by Janis Joplin. And there's a line that keeps getting repeated in it, and it says, freedom's just another word for nothing left to lose. And it's a fucking great line, because I don't own that glass, if it were mine, or that. It owns me. So that's the fear that we're going to lose all our possessions. Well, what are our fucking possessions? They're nothing, are they? They're pieces of junk, shite, trinkets that we get sidetracked with and offered, aren't they? It's shite. But once you realise that there's nothing to fear, my brother's in the audience, he's having a bit of a problem with some people at work, and he's sorted it out lovely. And what I realised is, and why I got rid of all those financial debts, I don't even know why I brought these, I'm not even consulting them. Why I got rid of all those financial obligations is one thing, is I've got no fear. And as soon as you lose the fear, things happen for you in the right order, exactly when you need them. And that's, people said to me, how come I don't pay for anything? And this is what I'm going to come on to now. I don't pay for anything at all apart from my mortgage. And people say, well, what do you do? And I just tell them, prove I owe it and I'll pay it. If you don't, fuck off or I'll charge you. And that's it. And much more clever people than me say, well, it shouldn't work. Why does it work? Because they'll come back with this and that legislation and this, or they'll ignore you. And I say, well, the reason it works is because I say it fucking works. That's why it works. I'm not frightened of these people. And I'm saying it, I'm telling them it works, because if I owe it you, I'll give it you. But prove I owe it, and they can never do that. And that's what it's all about. Lose that fear. Everyone's got, I don't mean lose it overnight, and you can all do it in varying degrees. Somebody can send an, you can send an email. Challenge your council tax people. Send them an email or a letter and say, what does this mean? What does it, I don't understand. In law, the inference is if you don't understand, if you don't understand, you don't stand under. If you don't stand under, you are not assuming liability. Nobody can take action on you if you do not understand. So challenge everything. If you're frightened of your bills and you want to learn a bit more, get on Get Out of Debt Free. Let's say it's a TV license. Okay, challenge them on every single word on that letter. You don't want to, it's a bit of letter writing. It takes about an hour at night time. Send them some letters or emails back off. Question: say, I don't understand this. But if you want to pay it, that's still all right until you're confident. But my idea, and it's a lot of people's ideas, is slow the whole fucking process up. Let's clog their system up with paper, letters, emails, text messages, whatever you want to do. The wheels of commerce were speeding along until about 2 years ago. They started slowing down now. And the more that we can clog their shite, and it's all fraudulent, by the way, that's why they can never prove it. The more we can clog their fraudulent shite system up with our stuff, I use my paperwork, not theirs, to keep sending it back at them, eventually those wheels of commerce are going to get slower and slower, and eventually going to grind to a fucking halt. And so, if you've got a bill, wait till the very last, don't get yourself in trouble if you're not confident, wait till the very last minute and then pay at the last minute. That's at least doing something. Do you know what I'm saying? I've told this story a couple of times on the radio show. I had a mate who were dating a girl who worked for the Ministry of Defence. She worked in the accounts department doing the budgets. This was about 2 years ago. I don't see him anymore now. But she said to him, spending that much money on the military, that the budget is that high now, that the price of a bullet, on average, is a quid. Okay, so basically, every pound that you and me stop them fuckers having, potentially, is a pound, a bullet, that may save someone's fucking life. Now, if we can save a pound, just think of it, we could save someone's life. Save a tenner, save hundreds, between Get Out of Debt Free and myself, but more the site itself, I would say now, is Salon still here or is he downstairs?
He's outside the door.
Okay. I would say that millions now have been saved from people not paying it. I was speaking to a chap at the beginning of the week, I've been helping him, he's been on Get Out of Debt Free, he owed 45,000 quid and has got rid of the whole fucking lot. And that's £45,000 that the other side, we're not giving it to them. And all it's about, all your tax money is all about, as you know, you've got to work, you pay your tax. What is your tax? It's a tax, A full space, T-A-X, or is it A-double-T-A-C-K-S, a tax? Okay, the tax that you're getting charged is really a tax, we're being attacked. The tax that they're raising from you is to one thing, to fund wars, mm-hmm. and that's it. Nothing else, nothing more. It's to pay back the fucking fraudulent loan from the banking cartel, it's to fund wars. It's to call the people, it's for many reasons, to create this fear.
Yeah.
Say again, Lee.
Population control.
Yeah, it's to call the population, it's many, many things. It's to cause fear, it's also sacrificial stuff, but that's for another talk maybe. Maybe satanic. Mm. What I'm saying is, the point I'm trying to make is, that every quid, I don't care if it's a penny, rather than a million quid. Every quid that we don't give them, and we keep for our loved ones and our families, and look after ourselves, is a quid less for them in it, and potentially we may be able to save somebody's life just from that one act, just from delaying your bills, that might be enough. Okay, did that even make sense anyway? Okay, so the reason I wanted to talk a little, no one's really covered money, so I'll cover a little bit about what I know about money, which is not a lot. I know Ceylon mentioned the bankruptcy early on. Two things are going off, and I'm sure you probably all know this, but we'll go over it. It's United Kingdom Corporation. Okay, everything's been corporatised, as we know. It's a corporate fascist takeover. There's two things, there's always duality. There's the United Kingdom, which is a geographical landmass. That's the country that we live in, Great Britain, England, whatever you want to call it. United Kingdom, there's a geographical landmass, and there's United Kingdom Corporation. Okay, every bill, debt, obligation, whatever, pertains to the United Kingdom Corporation and your legal name. Okay, United Kingdom geographical landmass, the corporation is bankrupt, that's what Salon was talking about. The country itself can't be bankrupt, it's a geographical landmass. We've got fertile ground, we've got resources, we've got everything. That's what they don't tell you. When they talk about United Kingdom being bankrupt and owing such and such money, they're talking about the corporation, not the country itself. Roughly, I don't know the exact figures, 204 countries in the world, might be 206, but let's say 204 countries in the world, 200 of them are bankrupt. Oh, hold on a fucking minute. Who do they owe it to? They're Mars. There's 200 countries all bankrupt and owe each other money. Well, why don't they just fucking write it off then? Okay, for one reason, and this is why we're in this shit, and this is what we can do. We can write letters and send emails to government. Fucking government.
Which are okay. Four countries that are not?
Pardon?
Said this.
I'm not sure, but
Bhutan's one of them.
Is it really? I'm not sure, but I think it might be. Get this. This is a coincidence. I'm not sure. Yet, so I mean, someone might correct me. North Korea, Cuba, Iran, Syria. Pardon?
I believe there's only three left at the minute, and it's the three countries they're going for, isn't it? Because they haven't got the Rothschild essentially on bank.
The IMF, yes. But there's Iceland. But I want to tell you a little bit about Iceland. I don't know a lot about it, but I found out somebody had mentioned earlier what Ministry of Justice, and everyone thinks it's just us. Put your hand up, don't be shy. Does anybody think justice
just them
means just us? Yeah? Okay, not many. I found out what it actually means and what I think it means, and it's not what you think. And this is why I think Iceland is not really being attacked, because they've come away and self-sufficient, aren't they? Very important word, ICE, ICE. Very, very important in my opinion, I'll tell you about it in a bit. Okay, so going back to money then. If we're bankrupt, which we are as a corporation, and that's what the government talk about, the national debt and all that bollocks, I'll try and talk this way a little bit. If it's bankrupt, then why is it bankrupt? Because one simple thing, my oldest lad is 13. 3 years ago, he was 10 years old. He solved the world's economy in one go, the country's economy rather. Okay, the issue, the creation and issue of currency should be done by the government themselves. And as we know, they've took back Anders, and it's allowed to be done by the Bank of England, the banking cartel. Trace it all the way back to the Rothschilds. I'm going to set up for the camera, just in case Nathan's listening. Bank of England, Federal Reserve in New York, They've got the monopoly on issuing and creating the money. It should be with government, like two American presidents tried it, didn't they? Kennedy and Lincoln, we all know what happened to them. Another one tried it, Andrew Jackson, which people aren't aware of. Does anybody know about Andrew Jackson? Third one tried it. Tried to assassinate him at gun jam twice. And luckily he retired from public life because he knew what were coming. So the ones that try and come away from the IMF get fucking wiped out, don't they? Every country that gets invaded, we can say it's oil, we can say it's gold, we can say it's this, it's coming away from the International Monetary Fund or the World Bank, the Zionist, and I'm not having to go at Jewish people or anything, Zionist, Rothschild, banking cartel. They create the money. Okay, what's the difference between an economic boom and an economic bust? Pardon? Exactly. All it is the amount of currency in circulation at any one time. It's fucking, the game's being played. So it's not new. It's thousands of years old.
Yeah.
And this is what's enslaving us. Okay. An economic boom, an economic bust is the... Okay, it's, remember, the power's with the banks, not the government. Okay. The amount of currency, actual cash, only makes up 3% of currency. Okay. So 97% is other electronic and checks. Oh. Credit cards and things, stiff neck here. Okay, so what do they do? Let's have a look. The banks are in control of it, remember. They issue the currency, okay, they boom it out. Okay, every business, you and I, credit cards, we get them thrown at us. There's loads of currency about. Everything's doing well, or seems to be doing well. The criteria for loans is lowered. So that, fucking, they get me a mortgage. I run about fucking 100 quid a week. I've got 162 grand mortgage. I think I run about 200 quid a week. He says, what figures do you want to put down? I went, yeah, have a look at that. He went, oh, well, times it by fucking times of income by 5.5 to get a mortgage out. I mean, I should have realised, but they throw it at you. So what they do is, the criteria for loans, for businesses as well, is the criteria is widened so much that anybody can get a loan. Then what they do is, bit by bit, and this is a plan over a few years, 5, 6, 7, 8 years, whatever it is, what they do is, they gradually constrict it and constrict it in the form of loans. Most companies, most businesses, big businesses run on loans. They at least have a 30 day, 60 day, 90 day, whatever, before they have to pay to keep, it runs on credit, doesn't it? Okay, so they gradually restrict it and restrict it and restrict it. So what happens is, the corporations still can't get the same credit that they would have had. So what happens is, confidence is lost in the sector, in the business and commerce sector. Jobs start getting laid off now, the orders aren't coming in because it's getting tighter and tighter, there's less money about, that's what they say, there's no money about. And all they do is constrict it, so eventually there's fuck all left. Anybody try and get a loan now? I don't know if anybody can, but you've got to have unbelievable credit now to get a loan, haven't you? And that's all they do is, it's a boom and a bust, and the idea is to restrict it and constrict it so much that jobs, people can't pay the loans back, the credit cards that they throw at them on purpose, and what do? All designed to take your personal property, and your, especially houses and mortgages, your real property back off you again. So it's a way of extracting it back off you. In another few years, when we come out of this, it'll be a boom again for a few years. They'll be lobbying fucking loans right, left and centre. Okay, and then all they do is bring it back in again. Why does that happen? Because it's the banking cartel that are in charge of the finances that issue and create the currency. Yeah? Okay, so if we are bankrupt, which we are, every pound, oh, it's a pound note, but I'm getting old, aren't I? Call it a pound note, it's a coin, isn't it? Every pound note that we spend is a debt. It never gets paid. The government have borrowed so much money from the banking cartel that the amount of interest, if it stopped right this second, not only could my kids not pay it off, but their kids could never pay it off, and that's if it stopped now. Somebody once asked Einstein what the greatest invention or discovery was, and he said compound interest. It's a figure that can never, ever, ever be paid off, and it's designed to be paid off. And this is why I do what I do. This is why I get a couple hundred emails a week, and I help as many people as possible. And this is what I mean. It's all fraudulent. Okay. We can't feed ourselves, and we have to use this legal tender at the moment. Now, there's things like the lawful bank, there's alternative currencies being spoken about, and different banking systems that are ours, belong to us, using different currency. At the minute we're a bit trapped, so this is why I say, don't give it them, make them prove that you owe it. Because every time we are spending a quid, I've just bought a Coke, well actually my brother bought it for me, so. Every time you're spending money, believe it or not, we are perpetuating the debt, we're adding to it because it's another debt. It's a debt that we are passing on. Okay, so as we know, as Sloan mentioned, when we think we're spending, this is the illusion, if you can get your head around the money, we've never paid for anything because we're operating in an equivalent of the United Kingdom Corporation is operating in a equivalent of a chapter...
Is it 33?
It might 30. Be, but last time I looked at it, we're 22 bankruptcy.
Yeah, yeah.
And all it really is it's a chapter 11 bankruptcy, and we've been in it twice, we've probably been in three now. Mm. So it's gone up from 11, 22, and it's 33, interesting numbers, eh?
Mm.
Yeah, very, isn't it? So that's what we're operating in now, as a United Kingdom Corporation. Chapter 22, at least chapter 22, probably 33 bankruptcy, and what it is debtors in possession, which means we're allowed to carry on trading in commerce as long as we make the monthly payments back to the banking cartels. So that's where we are. So every time we pass in £5 on, £10 on, a quid on, we're actually adding to the debt, aren't we? So when you get round to realising that I don't pay anything, and I'm not from this background, I'm from learning about energies and how the pyramids were, but that's where I come from for years and years. And out of necessity, I got to this bit. When everyone says, oh, Rob Freeman, he's that tosser who don't want to pay anything. And they're right, I am a tosser, and I don't want to pay anything. In fact, I don't pay anything.
I've just dropped that you don't want to pay.
Rob Freeman is a tosser, to your set. That's the first thing we've agreed on.
We might have a drink afterwards.
Don't have to pay for it. We write a promissory note for it. That's it. What Sloan said
is... you can forgive the debt.
We can forgive it, can't we? Oh, that's interesting, that.
Forgive our debts as we forgive those our debtors.
You know, yeah. You know that... is it the Our Father, Leah?
Forgive us.
Oh, okay. There was a hymn, forgive us. Is it the Our Father? Forgive
that's
our
Lord's Prayer.
Yeah, Lord's Prayer, is it? Forgive us our trespasses.
That voice in my head.
Yeah, it's not forgive us our trespasses, forgive us our debtors. Originally. It's been mistranslated.
Yeah,
right.
Correct.
Also, I'm getting shot off now. Shot off. I'm shot in a different direction. Terrible terminology. I'm shutting off here, but the 70-year bankruptcy cycle that Sloan mentioned is the 70 years and 10 mentioned in the Bible. It's a 70-year bankruptcy cycle, and that's the boom and bust that I keep talking about. What the hell were I about again? What were that cure for Alzheimer's that Sloan mentioned? I can't remember now, but I'm going to get it.
Coconut oil.
Pardon?
Coconut oil.
Coconut oil, right. I'm going to write that down because I'll forget that. How do you spell oil? I need some ackee. Scatterbrain, I'm getting worse. So we don't pay for anything, do we? Right, mate.
Hello, mate.
Oh, okay. Well, that's it. Yeah, so all we are doing is we're passing a piece of paper. It's a promise to pay. You could write it on that. You could write it on that. It could be anything. I once paid, you love this. I'll tell you a few of my experiences at the port I'm going to do. I once paid a 500 quid credit card, about 500 quid credit card bill, with a plastic poker chip from a poker set me and kids were playing with. And because they've accepted it, and I made them accept it, they never got back to me, so I paid £500 off with a plastic poker chip. Going back to parking tickets, I got 113 in 3 years. And like Sloan said, I got them on purpose. I once got 5 parking tickets in one day. And it got to a stage where, I took piss, because what I've done is I've been arrested 12 times now. I don't commit any crimes, these are for driving, and I won't give me details. And I've done it on purpose. I've lost 2 cars on purpose as well to see where we can get, what we can do, and I'll talk about cars in a minute. So I've been arrested 12 times, I've been to court 12 times for different matters, some of them enclosed. They've tried to repossess my house twice, and we'll talk about what I've come across with mortgages in a bit, interesting stuff. And so what I do is everything that I tell people, I live it first. And I'm not one to just fanny about, I'm not saying anybody should do this, you're a mug if you do this, and I am a fucking mug. Once I figured out what were happening, I just dived in and I thought, fuck it, I'll have a go, and I just started swimming. And like I say, it worked out. And it worked out because I'm confident. The only difference is between me and some people are not sure is that I've got the confidence to fucking have a goodbye. And that's what it is, because I'm not scared. What can they do to me? They can't do anything to me. Because I've done nothing wrong, and that's what you've got to keep remembering, you've done nothing wrong. If they've done nothing wrong, then show what are you claiming against me? Do you know what I'm saying? What are you saying I can or can't do? Prove it to me. And they can't. So what have I done wrong? And going back to Admiralty Maritime Law, the birth certificate, I'm sure most of you are aware of the birth certificate. yeah? Who's not aware of the birth certificate thing enslaving us, yeah? I've been to court over pathetic stuff, and I've stood and I won't stand in their dock, and I've said, are you telling me I'm a fucking slave? I'm a victim of human trafficking because me mum and dad were tricked into a birth certificate. I'm saying, are you telling me I'm a slave? Because fuck off, I'm not a slave. Or are you telling me I'm a slave because, I don't know whether you're aware of this, some fucking pope back in 1302 created, Pope Bonifaci created the first express trust in 1302, laid a claim of right that set up three more after that, that eventually enslaved everything, gave them a claim of right on our basically our hearts, minds, souls, our real property, our land and our personal possessions. I said to him, are you telling me I'm a fucking slave because some paedophile fucking pope back in 1302 did this? Fuck off. And I couldn't rebut it because I didn't know about it, but I know about it now and I'm fucking rebutting it. Are you telling me?
Fuck him. Put
him on notice. Yeah, I put him on notice. I'm just a lump from Sheffield. If I can do it, anybody can do it. I don't know, sadly. And I said, are you telling me I'm a slave because I'm Mr. Robert Freeman? I'm a ship, basically. I'm a commercial entity, a vessel, a legal. But I'm fucking not. I'm Rob. I'm just me. I'm a man. That's it. So are you telling me I'm a slave? What can the answer to that? They can't.
It wasn't actually a proper pope. It was a supreme pontiff.
Really?
The definition of supreme pontiff is the slave of slaves.
Is what? Sorry, let's speak up for the camera.
Of slaves.
Wow. So he was one of us.
The alleged ruler of all slaves. Okay. He was fired on the 12th of June 2011.
Fired? Or just
as
fired?
As in fired, get a new job.
Okay. Interesting stuff. Okay, so like I say, I'm not a slave. I refuse to be a slave. That legal fiction name thing, it's many things. It's also a trust, but I don't want to go into that today. I spoke about that a lot. It's many, many things. And it's a facility in commerce that we can use if we so desire. Okay, so just going back to that money thing. Sorry, not going back to that money thing. So I've done loads of different stuff.
I had a court case
a few months ago, driving whilst disqualified. Well, in fact, this will work out all right. Driving whilst disqualified. Basically, I got... I did a talk in an hotel, a country hotel. They charges extra for... We talk about trust, actually. They tried to charge us extra 13 quid for this room. In fact, one of the chaps who was with me is here today somewhere. And we had a bit of an argument with this management of this thing. And I said, there were four of us left out of the whole talk. And I said, do you want to we give them 13 quid? And the other three went, nah, fuck them. So I cut a long story short. Said to the manager of this country hotel, look, you're charging us for an extra hour that we've not had. I said, I'll tell you what, I'll give you my name and address and bill me, we'll come to some arrangement. I thought, I'll give her 6.5 fucking quid, like. In the end, she ends up calling police, she said, I want to call them. So we said, what, for 13 quid, you know, they'd like. I was in Sheffield, Chesterfield, that's where hotel were in Chesterfield. You just say like it is, don't you, like round here? I said, what, for 13 quid, you know, they'd. She went, yeah, I'm calling police. So I says to others, we waited an hour for police to come. That's how honourable we were trying to be. Coppers come. Big massive copper, I'll try and cut this short, and a woman, female copper. We were stood outside, around like four of us waiting. Fucking bored waiting, aren't I? Coppers come, in a big van. We said, we've had a bit of a dispute, but it's a civil matter, not to do with you lads. It's a civil matter, they're saying we owe money, we said we don't. I've offered to give my name and address. He says, right, he says, I'm going to go inside and have a word with management. He says, but I need I need all your details. So I say to other three, I'm not giving my details, which I don't, I'm under no obligation. The other three do, which is quite right if you want to. Said to the police officer, has a crime been committed? He went, well, I don't know yet. I says, well, all right. I said, well, I'm not going to give you my details. I says, if you're established that when you go in that the crime's been committed, I'm willing you give me details. But until that point, I'm under no obligation to give them you. He went, well, I'll arrest you. I went, when? He went, now. I said, well, you can't. I says, what? This is what I mean about questioning. I won't be clever, I'm nice and polite. Great big fat bastard, you were. I went, quote me the law that says that I am under obligation to give you any details when you've not ascertained whether a crime has even been committed. He didn't like it. He goes in, he comes out, dragging on forever, isn't it? He's only in 5 minutes, him and this woman, and they say, right, management have said forget it. Obviously, they've got no claim, have they? So I says, right, I said, everyone's free to go. He went, yeah. I says, no one's going to get arrested, no problems. He went, no. Everyone shoots off, coppers shoot off in the van, I'm the last one to leave the hotel. I'm going to this slip road to get onto the motorway. What do? I go past the police van. The police van's there, they're waiting for me on the road, aren't they? I thought, hello. I'm going one junction down the motorway to the services because I'm starving, I'm running out of fucking diesel light. So I go down one, it's about 3.5 miles down to slip road, first exit on the motorway, down to the service station, it's only about 3 miles away. Just as I'm pulling into the services, four police, that van that followed me and three others, I think it's called a T-manoeuvre, boxed me in. I think, hello, fucking hell, it's like I've robbed a bank. So I turn into the services, get out of my car, and the first thing I say is, that car's tax assessed and insured, which it was. As soon as I get out, eight of them dive on me and cuff me immediately. They keep my arms in air for 20 minutes while they're searching me, proper giving it to me. So they've arranged it, and all because, nothing to do with driving, because I wouldn't give me details. This is what I'm saying, don't be mugs, don't do what I've done. But I stood my ground. Anyway, cut a long story short, I end up 2 or 3 days in Nick, having fucking loads of time, got me on cell and everything, I can't fucking stand it. I don't eat anything because I'm thinking they're going to stick something in it. I don't have a cup of coffee. I'm like out with water and I just dab myself, so I didn't eat for about 2 or 3 days. Anyway, cut a long story short, I now get arrested for, get this, they arrest me and I get arrested for driving with no insurance. I'll tell you what happened after. Driving with no insurance, a non-arrestable offence, by the way. A bald tyre, a non-arrestable offence. Not giving me details in the service station. A non-arrestable offence unless they quote PACE. PACE is Police and Criminal Evidence Act. Unless they've got a reasonable suspicion that you've engaged in a crime or are about to, they have to quote PACE and they can arrest you for you're not giving your name. Well, nobody quoted PACE to me. So 3 non-arrestable offences and I spent fucking 2 or 3 days with Nick. Next morning, they then drag me out of cell because I won't offer fingerprints, and now they arrest me for driving whilst disqualified. Interesting, carries a 6-month sentence, or can do. So that's what they got me on, it's all to teach me a lesson, yeah? Drags on and on and on, it's like this story, dragged on and on and on. For nearly 6 months, I go to court, I do the trust stuff in court. I walk into court and I say to magistrates, you and your public servants, blah, I get it all on public record. I sack everybody off. I fucking walk out and I beat them and they can't beat me. I've done everything right. What do they do? 2 coppers come to my house with a fake warrant that I never saw and arrest me from my house as a no-show in court. This is what I mean. They're having to do unlawful things. This is how close we're getting, folks. We're getting really close. They're having to commit crimes just to keep on top of what they're already doing, if that makes sense. So I get arrested and locked up again, very conveniently, Saturday morning. So I'm in prison all till Monday. Don't be a mug, don't do what I've done, getting out of work. I end up, I'm on prison bus. Everyone's saying, what are you in for? He went, armed robbery, what are you in for? Oh, well, I stabbed someone, what are you in for? Driving whilst disqualified. Everybody started laughing at me. So I'm on prison bus, and they do my case last of all. Fucking 3 o'clock, half 3 afternoon, I'm in a holding cell. So I've now been locked up 3 days here. So they're trying to teach me a lesson, aren't they? Anyway, cut a long story short. Short story long, it's going somewhere, honestly. I'm just trying to show you what can be done with a bit of this and a little bit of this with a pair of steel toe caps. I get adjourned, and eventually they said to me, if you don't plead guilty, I adjourn it, and they say, if you don't plead guilty now, after they lock me up, we're going to request the maximum sentence. Driving whilst disqualified can give a 6-month prison sentence. You know, I'm a single parent, I can't afford to get locked up. So anyway, it gets adjourned, and then finally, court date comes up, I take some people with me. I think I've got a good chance here, so I think, well, it's a bad time to experiment, but I'm going to experiment. I'm actually going to stand in dock, and I'm going to play by their game, and see if I've got a chance of winning. A 3-hour fucking trial. You know, Charles Manson only had 2 hours. A 3-hour fucking trial over driving offences. I've got a Crown Prosecution Service barrister, he wasn't about that big, he was smaller than me, so I'll keep that in. But Crown Prosecution Service barrister on 9 zillion quid a fucking minute. 3 magistrates, it's gone on for nearly 6 months, they've just cut it short of 6 months. So now they wanted to give me maximum thing. And clerk to the justices, who's, I don't know if you know, but he advises the magistrates, he's the one who calls the shots. Yeah. So I'm in a 3-hour trial. What the fuck? I've got all my mates in public gallery, I'm waving to them like that. I'm like a proper barrister sat at the front like that, and all my mates are waving to me. I think, fucking, whatever happens, happens. Anyway, this is what point I want to get to. What you can do is a little bit of research. And I'm no smarter than anybody else. It's just that when you know you're right, and like I said, when you're coming from here and you're doing what's right, it falls in place for you, as and when you need it. We'll talk to this side a little bit. Okay, so a 3-hour trial. Okay, I end up interrogating the two police officers that attended that hotel at first place and were there on the arrest. Okay, I interrogate this female copper. They both couldn't wait to get off the stand. I'm like, who that famous lawyer? Was it fucking Perry Mason or something? I don't know. Chubby Mason then. And I'm really good at it. I can't believe I'm making a career out of this. So I interrogate the female copper and I says, what's the process of first charge, driving with no insurance, we're on a trader's policy. I says, what's the process of, what's the standard procedure for a vehicle with no insurance? She says, well, we impound it. I says, was my vehicle impounded? It weren't. She went, no. I went, why not? She said, well, we couldn't ascertain whether it was insured or not, so we give you the benefit of the doubt. Thank you very much. Charge number one, fuck off. Okay, so I'm buzzing. Get rid of that one. That's not the big one. Charge number two, driving with a bald tyre. Over at the bald head. Driving with a bald tyre. As I said, I joke every time, it's crap every time. Driving with a bald tyre. Okay, I conceded that. I said, show me the law that says I'm obliged to even speak. Well, we use PACE. You've got to quote PACE, Police and Criminal Evidence Act. Reasonable suspicion that you're a criminal. They have to quote it that they're arresting you under PACE to take you in, to get your name and address in box, to see further inquiries, basically. Did you, me talking to the male copper, did you quote PACE? No, we utilised it. Did you quote PACE? No, we utilised it. You can't utilise PACE, you have to quote it to the person you're arresting. Magistrates, Mr. Freeman, can we move on, please? Charge number three, fuck off. Okay. I'm doing alright here. The mates are waving to me and I'm thinking, well, I'm alright here, that's three gone. Big one now. It's dragging on forever, isn't it? Are we even going to talk about this? Why has this popped into my head? I'm just trying to show you. Hold on a minute. You're taking action on me because I don't want to be a government agent and work for you. Well, that's exactly why I fucking sent the license back in the first place. Because I don't want to work for you. Thus proving my point. So you can never ever be banned from driving. You can never be disqualified. All they can do is make it ineligible for you to be to serve in office, to work for the government. Mr. Rob Freeman in Block Capitals is a government agent. Well, that's not me, is it?
Correct.
Okay. So I went through it all, brilliant. I'll make this quick, it's dragging on, I want to get up some more stuff. They retire for half an hour. Half an hour? Well, that's a long time. We're all studying for you. That mate's here who came with me, I don't know if he's still here. We're all studying for you, and Barrister walks past me and goes like that. Pulls a really strange, evil face, and we all laughed. And all my mates went, that's crap, 15 people were made. In fact, I've got a transcript, everybody wants it. I'll send you a transcript that we made, a friend of mine made. Fucking, I was dragging on forever. I'd have been better doing 6 months sentence, wasn't I? yeah, so half an hour. I've lost myself, I'm laughing myself there. Half an hour's gone by. They retired. All right, okay, come back for the verdict. Okay, get this. Brilliant. Charge number one, driving without insurance, guilty. Hey? Oh, okay. Charge number two, bulk tyre job, guilty. And the mate's okay, it was making no rules up as to go along, aren't we? Charge number three, what were it? Not giving details, guilty. Oh, fucking hell. Big one. Okay, I look at the mates and I think we'll be all right. They'll give me this one. Charge number four, driving whilst disqualified, guilty. Wow. I beat you on all four counts, and I'm guilty on all four counts. I just look at my mates and they all go, what more can I do? I beat them on everything. This is how corrupt they are now. This is how far gone these fucking psychos have gone.
So who gave them permission to change the law, Rob?
Pardon?
Who gave them permission to change the law?
They don't need it, do they? This is what I'm saying. But get this. I'm sorry this story's dragging on so much. I've told it a few times. People are wondering, I've had enough of this, right? But it is a good story, really. So, okay, I'm found guilty on four charges. The lead magistrate, the one in the middle, says, we recommend that you have a 6 months prison sentence. Well, I'm in a state now, aren't I? I've got two kids to look after, I've got no help. So, quickly, I jump up, quick thinking, because I'm really quick at thinking, believe it or not. I look sober, I'm really, really sharp in my mind. I said, please delay sentencing, I've got two children to sort out. Promising a bit of time. He goes, right, this is a Tuesday morning. He went, right, come back Thursday for your sentencing. So I'm gutted now. They've recommended that if I don't plead guilty, I get 6 months in prison. And now they're pushing for it now, they've got it now, they can just give it me. So I'm at their mercy, and I'm, yeah, I beat them. What more can I do? Okay, I go back Thursday morning. Say goodbye on my radio show, say goodbye to everyone. I've got one mate comes with me, he gave me a mobile phone. think this is it, sentence of sin. I'm prepared to do 6 months, fuck them. I've got my family to look after, my kids. I'm going to lose my house anyway at this stage, but fuck it. It's just a house, isn't it? And all my kids are well looked after. Okay, I go in for sentencing. I'm going to see probation officer first. Oh, it's a long story, but I'm just trying to tell you what is capable. Sorry, guys, I'm going to close it up here. This story. Go and see probation officer woman. She says, right, they'll lie. They'll lock you up for 6 months, put you on an electronic tag, or give you some sort of community hours, or all three, or any combination of all three. I says, I'm not, I won't have tag. I says, talk to bollocks, I'm not having tag. I'm I think it's a bit quick. I said, I'm electro-sensitive. Just come to me. She said, what do you mean? I says, well, I said, every time I go in the electrical object, it makes me feel really poorly. I went, look, I'm not like a strange son. And she went, oh, right, I've never heard of that. She goes, would your doctor confirm that? I went, oh, yeah, it's going on. I said, I'm electro-sensitive. I says, computers burst and everything. Right, I'm clumsy, just fucking knock them all over, but she don't know. So I don't want to go for tag because I know it's got some terrible things. So my options are, I get locked up, or do community service, or do both. Okay, so I'll get to court, same court, little district judge, little old fellow like that, one woman typing, that probation officer I've seen, and me, and my mate in public gallery, what was happened to all these horrible people? Cheers, mate. Sorry. Gets in, district judge, says, do you want to be called Robert or Robert? I went, well, Robert will do, right? He's a clap after this because he's gone for fucking ever, hasn't he? He says, right, he says, do you want to have a seat, Rob? I thought, no, it's going off, so I'll sit down. I mean, I expect to sit on a load of fucking fines, aren't I? He says, he's shuffling some papers about. He says, would you like to stand up, Rob? I'm thinking, fucking hell, it's going off for you. I've never known anybody be so nice. He went, right, he says, we're here just for sentences only. He says, all the facts, you've been found guilty. He says, I can't discuss that. I thought, I know you can't. It's a fucking meter, isn't it? He went, right, he says, driving no insurance, you've been found guilty. He went, oh, he says, we'll not have a fine for that. I thought, lovely. He said, I'll stick some points on your licence, a couple of points. I thought, you're sticking some points on a licence that I fucking sent back in. So I looked around at my mate like that, and he just went, my mate just on his own just went. He went, driving with a under tread tyre, or whatever, driving with a bolt tyre. He went, oh, right. He says, we'll not have a fine for that. He says, I'll stick a couple of points on your licence. I thought, fucking yes, go on, my son. Not giving me details, never mentioned it. I looked at my mate and I thought, come on, bro, I'm not listening, like, three charges gone, like. So did I lose, really? He went, oh, this is like a little kid on like a kid's fucking entertainment film. He went, oh, oh. No, I didn't say that. He went, yeah. Remember that? He went, driving whilst disqualified. He went, oh. And I'm being stood up, just like, oh. He went, right, he says, I've been, what did he say? Trying to get the right terminology used. He says, I've had a recommendation that we give you the maximum sentence, 6 months. He says, but I'm not going to do that. And then he paused. I thought, fucking, it's going to be 3 months, isn't it? He went, you've had a word with probation officer, haven't you? I went, yeah. He says, you're keen to do a bit of voluntary work, aren't you? Because when I spoke to her, she said, do you mind helping homeless out? Would you like to do that? Instead of getting locked up, I went, you know. Only 2 minutes from where I live. He went, you're keen to help do a bit of voluntary work, aren't you, one day a week with some homeless people? I went, yeah. He went, well, that can be a punishment then. He says, well, I'll have a fine for that. He says, well, I'll stick a couple of points on your licence. I think you've lost me enough. So it is possible, but because I took so many 12, 15 people with me, he didn't want to show that I'd beat them. Now it was just me and my mate, and they didn't even know you were there. On my own, little district judge, I'd have had a beer with him, we were all right. So they've not took any action or fined me or anything yet. I'll finish it off and I'll go on to something else. How long have we got left, folks? It's dragging on, isn't it? No, okay, right. I'll just close up on this, finish on a bit of good stuff and then I'll come out later for you. I'll throw stuff at me. He went, right, money. He said, he says, barristers put a, get this, he says, barristers put a cost in for £775. He went, ooh, but you're not paying that, Rob, are you? And I thought, fucking hell, I'm not. And I got this from Dean Clifford, he says to me, and he was desperately trying to help me and it's consent again. He went, how does £350 sound? And I looked at him as if to say, it sounds like something I'm not going to fucking pay. Because I got away with so much, I thought, I can't put it. And I went, I pulled a right, like, pathetic face. I went, as if to say, I don't want to pay it. And he went, get this, he went, ooh. He ended this, he went, ooh. You're a single parent, aren't you? I went, yeah. He went, can you manage a fiver a week? And I went, Go on then, it's my push boat out. So that's what costs, yeah? And then the last thing he said is, he says, Rob, you might like this idea, I've got two options. He said, give the clap after this, because I've been alright here. He says, you might like this idea. He says, if you apply for your license now, reapply for it. He says, you're not banned anyway, you can carry on driving. I said, I like that option. He went, I mean, fuck off, like. So all that's happened is, I volunteered to do a little bit of voluntary work for some homeless people that live near me, and I help them out, and that's all gone away now. I've agreed to go halves on the other side's cost, which I've never paid a fucking penny, because it's not a fine, so I don't have to pay it. It's an agreement, isn't it? Let's contract. Fuck off. You never asked me. All I've got is 6 points shoved onto an invisible license that doesn't exist that I sent back fucking years ago. So, did I lose or did I win?
Rob was successful in getting into the lower end of the court of equity. That judge was able to act in equity. Equity regards that as done, which ought to be done, as if it was being done to the judge himself. And that was the only powers he had to assist him at the time. Had you filled an N161 and appealed it, you would have gotten it all squashed by chance.
Okay, and that's what I need to get. That's nice one. That's part of the learning process. I didn't know enough. And this is what I'm talking about today. Not suggesting anybody get in any sort of trouble like this. But that's me. I'll have a chat with you after. This is what I need to progress to now. I've done all the stuff, so it makes the things like water rates, for instance. Fuck off. You can't cut me off anyway. I'm not bothered. I'm trying to push the boat out. To learn as much as I can, and that's the next step now. Okay, so that's what we're getting to with that. Yeah, well, that was such a long story, that, weren't it? Sorry. But I'm just trying to show you that. No, I've not learnt this. Nobody's taught me this. And I don't, I'll be honest, I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. I ain't got a clue. But does anybody know what they're doing? I don't fucking know what I'm doing. But one thing I do know, I don't profess to be intelligent or anything. But one thing I do know is that it feels right. And if it feels right, I'm not doing it wrong. Well, unless somebody can prove I'm doing something wrong, fuck off, I'm going to fight it all the way. Not physically, because that's what they want, we don't want that. But everything you come back at me with, I'm going to come back even better at you, because I'm doing nothing wrong. And that's to save me your bills and everything, that's what I'm trying to get out today. If you're not doing anything wrong, it means you're acting in honour. If you're doing something wrong, you're acting in dishonour. It's correct. All about honour and dishonour.
Correct.
You always act honourably, don't cause harm to another living soul.
Correct.
And things will get handed to you. Okay. Pardon?
Honour is the highest rule.
Absolutely. So we act honourably, we always stay in honour. And these fuckers are in dishonour. Okay, so what I'm trying to say is that although they claim that they beat me, they didn't beat me on anything, did they? They never had a penny off me, and neither has anybody else. Okay, so that was a load of bollocks, weren't it? It went on forever. And it's nothing about what we're going to write about, what I've written about here. Just a quick couple of quotes. Quick couple of quotes. This is nothing what I've got prepared at all. Couple of quick quotes, and I'm just going to tell you my experiences with cars and mortgages, mortgages being the big one. Okay, not that I'm any sort of authority on mortgages whatsoever, but I'm going to have a go, and I'll tell you why I'm going to have a go. And if I win, it's going to set a precedent for everybody that has a mortgage or knows somebody who's got a mortgage. And I'm not saying I'm really clever, because I'm not, I don't even know what I'm doing, but it will work out and I will do it. And I will do it because I say I'm going to do it, because I'm doing nothing wrong. Okay. Incidentally, just before that Crown Prosecution Service case, I'm just going back to it, I actually rung them up and said, before the court case, I tried to act honourably. I gave them 7 days Crown Prosecution Service to back out and leave me alone, and they didn't. I said, I phoned them up and I said, excuse me, to this woman, can you just tell me which Crown you are? She said, oh, she went, hello Crown Prosecution Service. I said, oh. She was really friendly. I said, I thought I got this or something, you're really nice, you. She went, oh, thank you. I said, can you just tell me which Crown you are, please? And then she fucking changed. She went, what do you mean? I said, well, is everybody aware that there's two Crowns operating at least? Mm-hmm. Yeah? Does anybody not know? No. Okay, oh, brilliant. Okay, I'll just go over quickly. There are two Crowns that I know of. There may be more, maybe Triple Crown, but two Crowns are operating. Queen Elizabeth from the House of Windsor is one. The other one is the Crown Corporation, it's City of London,
correct.
The square mile.
Yeah.
That's where all the laws, it's where all the solicitors, barristers are all, judges are all part of the bar, the bar is it? The Law Society.
Yeah, Temple Bar's there.
Temple Bar,
yeah.
That's the one. Yeah. So there's two crowns going off. Whenever the crown takes to court, it's the crown corporation, that's all. Yeah. A corporation.
Free, your crown.
Pardon?
Free, your crown.
Yeah, it's a triple crown. A corporation's got no jurisdiction over you whatsoever, and the crown that they talk about, that's supposed to look like Queen Elizabeth, is a crown corporation, it's a private corporation. They've got no jurisdiction over it. All they can do is extend the offer of a contract to you. And that's what they trick you in. Okay, so I ring them up and I say, can you tell me which crown you're representing? She said, I don't know what you mean. I said, well, are you in fact representing Queen Elizabeth from the House of Windsor? Or are you representing the City of London Crown Corporation? She didn't know what to fucking say. She went, I don't know what you mean. So eventually, after winning her in, she said, we're representing Queen Elizabeth II. She said, the other one's got nothing to do with us. I went, wow, thank you very fucking much. Bye bye. Boom. Notice. Give them 7 days. I've just spoke to one of your employees. She's very unsure who you're even representing. If I can't identify the accusing party, they can't be a fucking court case, can they? Please tell me you've got 7 days to respond. I've got a court case coming up. You've got 7 days to respond. Are you in fact representing Queen Elizabeth II or are you representing the Crown Corporation? That's what I asked them. They didn't get back to me, and I waited right up the day before. He didn't know how to answer it, and it still went ahead. If you had said, we represent Queen Elizabeth II, I don't know if anyone is, I thought I've got a cast iron case here. If they would have said, we represent Queen Elizabeth II, is anybody...
It's constitutional law, isn't it?
Is anybody, is anybody familiar with Muad'Dib, his defence, that the Queen's coronation is fraudulent? He used that as a defence and won. So if they had come back and said, we represent the Queen Elizabeth, boom. More they've sent it, mate. Boom, sorry, it's all fraudulent, fuck off. If they'd have said, we represent the Crown Corporation, thank you very much, can you just show me the contract that obligates me in any way, shape or form to yourself? I don't know who you are. If you don't show me the original contract or a copy of it, no contract, no obligation, fuck off. So that's why they didn't answer back. And that's why the barrister was looking at me. Does anybody know what the trading name is of, the proper trading name is of... In fact, if anybody knows this, I'll give them a tenner. I hope nobody knows. Hold on a minute. The Crown Corporation trade under a very similar name to the Queen's. Anybody know what it is? Just speaking to it, I'm looking. What is it? Her Majesty in Right of England. Wow, how similar to that? How similar to Queen Elizabeth? Well, it's a contract I've got to oblige you now. So the Crown Corporation. Oh, you cost me a tenner, that fucker. The Crown Corporation, do you want to come and get your tenner? The Crown Corporation trade as a private corporation, Her Majesty in Right of England is there for fucking. So, just for you, hold on, I've got a tenner in change here.
Don't worry about the tenner, mate.
No, contract's a contract.
I'll tell you what, I'll leave it with you.
Just give me two. As I'm talking, I'll get you a tenner out, it's going to like this.
No.
Have a drink of me. That's as valuable as a 10 quid now. It's just the fucking same, mate.
Her Majesty and Crown.
You can check it out. Her Majesty, in nice, great answer, by the way. And same with, where's he gone with the other chap? Her Majesty in Right of England, that's what they're trading as, that's their proper trading title.
Her Majesty in Right of
England. Her Majesty in Right of England. Okay. Oh, I like that 10 quid. I like that better than the other 10 quid, to be honest. You want to swap it later?
Sell it if you want.
20 quid. Okay, I've got about 15 minutes left, so I'll wrap up now. It's been a lot of awesome, hasn't it? Okay, I'll tell you what we'll do. Just bear with me. Okay, I'll tell you a little bit about what I'm doing with, excuse me, cars. 5 minutes on cars. 10 minutes on mortgages. I'll read you some maxims of law that you can always use. And then fuck off, Harry, out faces. Okay, cars. When I first started this 5 years ago, I told people, stay away from houses, mortgages, stay away from cars. The
the more value that's perceived in that object, the more the criminal press are running onto it, aren't they? And they're going to put up a right fight, aren't they? And so, according to them, your most valuable possession is your house and your car and your children, basically, isn't it? And that's why we register these things, don't we? And I'm sure people know that when you register something, when you register, you, in effect, give title ownership over to them, and we get a user's entitlement. Otherwise, how could they ever take it back off you? It'd be theft, wouldn't it? It's because we signed the right over for them to do that. That's why your children can get taken off you, mm-hmm. you get your house repossessed, you get your car taken off you. We get a user's entitlement by registering it. Okay. Is everybody not aware of that, the registering? And it doesn't matter if you're not, because we're all there to learn. Is everybody aware of that? Yeah, because I know there's a lot of new people here. Okay, whenever you register anything, you are giving up title ownership to whichever authority you are registering it to, yeah? Okay, and then what
only
comes back?
Half. Eh? Only one half. Oh. On either side, not yet.
Yes, I'm not going to go into equity links too, much there, but yeah, you're right, you are right, I think. Okay, so you get a user's entitlement. As long as you use it to their rules, you're allowed to carry on. Do you want to come back? It's all right. Honest, I don't buy it. Yeah, so you're allowed to use it. You're allowed to use it as long as you do as they say. Okay. So what I realised is I spent 5 minutes on this. I kept getting experiment. I told everybody, don't do houses, don't do cars. And then, so soon I told everybody, I started doing houses and cars. I kept getting DVLA, kept clamping my car outside my house for not having a tax. I think my neighbour were grassing me up. So I'd just go and get electric. My mate turned up a chain, helped like one of them horror movies, chopped it off. I kept chopping it off. And they kept doing my cars, and I kept chopping fucking clamps off and throwing them away. And I was experimenting. I'm only buying cars worth £200. I've lost 2 cars now, but I've kept about 5. And I was experimenting just what we can and can't do with cars. This is what I mean. Everything I'm telling you, I'm not a fucking muppet who just sits there typing, passing information. I get out there and I live it. And I try my best to, and then I try and pass that information on. And you learn so much by suffering, basically. And I've fucking learned a lot this last 2 years, I can tell you. And so what I realised is they put me a sticker on car every time they clamp me. And what it says it's a big red sticker, so it's subliminal, so it's red, so it makes you panic. And it says every car registered in the UK must have a valid tax test and insurance, whatever, on a red sticker there every time. Okay, so I get this sticker, I kept chopping clamps off, and I'm trying to find a way what we can do. You are registered, so you're the registered keeper. I got my mate to phone up DVLA and said, I'm blah blah blah, I'm the registered keeper, I'm such and such. She went, yeah. He said, well, I own it. She went, I know you do. He said, well, can you send me a piece of paper that says I'm the owner? She went, no. He said, why not? He says, she said, well, we do that in case it's a company. I don't know why I'm doing that, it's not even a fucking phone, is it? Not a very good one. It's better than what I've got. She says, well, we send registry in case it's a company vehicle. He says, well, it's not. He says, I don't want a bit keeper. He says, I paid money for that equity. He says, I'm the owner. He says, will you send me a piece of paper saying I'm the owner? She went, no, bye. So they don't want us owning it, do they? They want us with a keeper. So it played on my mind. Every vehicle registered in the UK must have valid tax and insurance. Okay. My mate's called Rob. There's only 2 people visiting me, three people visiting me. My mate, he's called Rob as well, he knows a little bit. I went, Rob, read that. You read it, read it, read it, you read it. So that's what I'm doing. Read it, read it. He read it 3 times. I says, what's that say, Rob? He says, every vehicle registered in the UK must have valid tax and insurance. He says, well, you've got to fucking register your vehicle. I went, oh, no. Read it again. He read it eventually, twig like he did with me. I says, do you see what I mean now? He went, yeah. Every vehicle registered in the UK must have valid tax assessment. Not every vehicle has to be fucking registered. These people craft these words, these sentences. You've got to look in between the words and interpret it your own way. Every vehicle registered in the UK must have tax assessment insurance, blah, blah, blah. Not every vehicle has to be registered. Okay, I'm on it. How do you not register a vehicle? Okay. I've got 2 mates who own a car pitch. Small car pitch, I buy my cars off them. They sell me a car, I only buy cars worth £700 and they let me have them for about £400 or £500. I've told the story before, I'll make it quick. Okay, they sell me the car, they relinquish any connection with that car, I've got a bill of sale, no problem. There's a slip of paper where you have to fill in and send it back.
to volunteer to be the new registered keeper. Yeah, is everybody familiar with that? We'll just dry. I don't send that off. Fuck off. I don't send that off. I'm not volunteering. No, it's my car. I've got equity in that car. It's mine. Correct. I don't care. All the legal shy. Mm-hmm. You can view the car as a seagoing vessel or me, or I don't care. Put money into that car. It's mine. Okay. How does it work? I don't fucking know. It doesn't work. It only works because I believe, well, I know it works. That's the only reason it works. It's because I say it works. Okay, I found out you can't deregister. If you try and deregister the car as a keeper, you have to use their paperwork and you can't deregister. Okay, the last time I got arrested, that time I told you when they swamped me in services, the cop had made one mistake. He said to me, your car's coming back as unregistered. Whoa, and then it fucking hit me. I had to get arrested and go through the court case and do the fucking timing to understand your car's coming back as unregistered. Whoa. Big difference. Deregister, unregister. Massive difference. That's what got me to realise. I've got three people who are driving about now in an unregistered vehicle. One woman's been doing it a year. Other two have been doing it about 6 months, and I do it as well. The vehicle's unregistered. We've put it into a trust, a family trust, nothing complicated. We've just wrote it down and said it's in a fucking trust. We do insure it. The woman insures a car because if she runs into someone that's only right, she doesn't put tax on it, she doesn't put test on it. She must have had 150 coppers pull up and look at her and drive off. Okay, so what I'm saying is, I buy a car off the mates, I don't fill in the slip, okay, it's now become unregistered. When I did get arrested, they told me it had been impounded. It weren't, it was selling services, never been touched. Why? Because it was unregistered. That particular car had done it. Also, the service station people told me DVLA had put a ticket on the car for it being there for a few days. When I got there, there was no ticket. They must have ripped it back off. Why? Because it's not registered. It's not deregistered. That's still in their system. It's unregistered. Okay. All I did is wrote to DVLA and told them I am now the owner of the vehicle, blah, 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 blah. It's been held in the Freeman Family Trust, okay? Any communication from yourselves must be made to the duly appointed administrator of the Freeman Family Trust, whose name is Rob Freeman. Okay, so all I've done is put it into a trust that's fictitious anyway, but it don't have to be fictitious, it can be what I want it to be. Fuck it. I put the car in a family trust that's unregistered, and I've big difference, registering never, record always. I've recorded that I am the owner, that the trust is the owner, and I am the general executor or administrator of the trust. And any communication from now on must be made to the administrator stroke executor. Okay, so for police purposes and DVLA, I'm telling them that I am the owner of the car. What's happened is they've acknowledged that woman, that she's the owner. They've never sent me anything back, and the other two chaps have been acknowledged. For some reason, I've not had an acknowledgement of DVLA that I am the owner of the car. Okay. So far, I'm the one that's been probably doing it least on this particular car. None of them have got done yet. None of them have got pulled. I don't know how good this is. We want to run it through a bit further yet and make sure it's... I was on get out of debt free and I wanted to put the information out. But quite rightly, I was told, don't put it out yet unless we know it works. It's coming up for a year, it's not quite long enough. But this is something really simple, this. And I don't think for 1 minute I've got it 100%, but we're getting there. Do you know what I mean? We're getting there. So that's what I've found out about cars, anyway. Yeah?
Did you do anything with your reg plate? We tried to deregister the car and we got a letter back saying you can't do it, but they highlighted that like their registration mark had something to do with it.
Well, do you know what I found out? And I might be wrong, but it's further investigation on my part. Is you can't deregister. They won't let you deregister. Yeah, yeah. You're still in their system. I don't think they own the car. I think they own the fucking plate.
Yeah, yeah. When you sent your license back, did you send any paperwork with it?
When I sent the license back. When I sent the license back.
Yeah.
Yeah. I forgot to tell you, I handwrite everything. I just screwed up.
Did you deny its existence? Or
no, I told them it was contractual in nature, which it was, and said, thank you very much. I refuse your contract. I don't want to partake in it.
So it's been through that process of all deregistering our cards?
Not deregistering,
unregistering our cards.
Yeah.
How would we go about that process?
Well, I wouldn't want to advise anybody to do it, and I wouldn't suggest anybody does it, but what I'm saying is, we've had just less than a year yet. In another year, we're going to know it works for definite and we can tweak it. The thing to do is,
if you've already got, that's a good question actually. Oh, I'm dragging on this. People have said to me, it's all right for you because you bite off your mates and you don't have to feel happy. And what if I want to keep the car I've got? I said, right, which is in effect what you're saying, isn't it? Are you already the registered keeper?
Well, it's about proving whether you're the registered owner.
Okay. If you want to keep your car and you're okay, if you want it, I'm going to have to close up in 10 minutes. About 10 minutes, Paul?
Yep.
Okay. I'm trying to squeeze this in. If you've already got a car and you're already the registered keeper, what's that all happen? If you want, I don't know why I'm doing that, it just looks very good for me after these glasses. If you want to keep on being the registered, I'll start again. I'm Rob Freeman. If you are the registered keeper of a car, I'm trying to rush, sorry. If you are the registered keeper of a car and you want to keep that car, but you can't deregister what you do, what one of these chaps I've got to tell you did, he sold the car. Imagine it's me, I sell the car to the Freeman Family Trust. Okay. Rob Freeman don't own that car, it's held in a trust now. Okay? Then the Freeman Family Trust notify DVLA that they are now the new owners of the vehicle. Yeah?
So step one is create that paperwork.
Step one is to create a trust on paper, sell the vehicle, this is what that woman's done by the way, sell the vehicle to the trust. She's got notification back that she's no longer the registered keeper. The trust have got notification back that they are the owners. Any communication, imagine it's mine, I sell them, I'm no longer the keeper, I sold it to the Freeman Family Trust, bye. They send me notification, you're not the keeper. The Freeman Family Trust own the car, they get notification. We're recording that we're owning, not registering, we're recording it. Any communication to the Freeman Family Trust must be done through the general executor or administrator, Rob Freeman. It's back to me again, which then you can go and insure it. Okay, does that make sense?
Yeah.
So create a trust, sell it to the trust, have a bill of sale. It's a trust, isn't it?
So you're not filling in the B5s anymore?
Pardon?
You're not filling the family trust on the
B5? They don't use any of their paperwork whatsoever.
But is the creation of the trust, is the trust created by you just sending that paperwork?
Yeah.
Why was it? Just don't want to say, my research on trust is it can be verbal, you can set up a verbal trust. A lot of people.
So, merely writing it on a piece of paper. Well, trust.
Well, Lee might correct me on this, but we haven't got time, so we might have to do it later on. But in my own, and I say it works for me because I want it to work, and so it works, is I can create a trust, it's a private family trust. Nobody can come in between my trust, it's my fucking trust. This is what they're doing to us, this is what they're doing in court.
So
they construct a trust in court, verbally,
so you
have dissolved it.
The DVLA backs up the fact that you created a trust.
No. Me informing the DVLA is that the trust has bought that vehicle. I don't have to prove to anybody that fucking trust exists. You prove to me, and this is where I'm coming from today, I'm going to wrap up soon, just tell you about mortgages. Mortgages. That's mortgages, by the way. that's I can't be fucking mortgages. I'm not telling them. I'm telling them that Rob Freeman sold the car to a family trust called Freeman Trust. It's not up to them. You fucking disprove to me that I haven't got a family trust. How are you going to do that?
Right.
Unless they've got some sort of seal or that warrants they've got authority. It's a fucking private family trust. Fuck off. Excuse my language, by the way, maybe. I can't accent. I get a bit excited.
If you did a statutory declaration as well,
wrong bit. Say again.
If you did a statutory declaration and sent it off and that's supposed to be put on public record,
is that you saying
DVLA, etc., you've got something there that if they do dispute it, then it's out of their jurisdiction and goes to a higher court because it's a jury court.
Okay. So are you saying to do a stat? Are you saying to do a stat then?
As well, just do a stat then.
See, this is what I mean. It's not perfect, it's worked, but I do need a bit of help with it, and it's something we can all do.
Mm-hmm.
Guys, sorry. Just leave the questions. I want to get Rob Pollock on in a bit after this. Yeah. So. I'm going to have to finish up it. I'll tell you what, I'm staying for most of the day, so I'll be. If you want me, I'll be slumped in the corner at bar twitching like that, so just come and ask me anything. And I'm not rushing off today, so and I will answer your questions. Okay, so that's how many cars. I'll come off cars now. I just want to talk to you. 10 minutes? 5
yeah.
minutes?
Yeah, 10 minutes. Cool.
10? Yeah, cool. 10 minutes, I'm going to push off. I don't even know why I brought these notes. Okay. Oh no. Fuck me, yeah. Let me address this morning. I don't know. It's off, isn't it? Yeah, so don't touch houses, mortgages, don't touch cars. And like I said, I touch mortgages and cars. So that's cars. I'll go into detail after. So mortgages, okay. The only thing left, the only financial obligation I've got, the only financial obligation I've got left is mortgages. I asked them for the three things 2011, I thought I'll have a go at this. I made a decision 4 years ago, 3 years ago, I'm never going to pay for anything because we don't pay for anything, as I said, like I said. And I thought, well, if we're not paying for anything, why am I fucking killing myself to try and pay for something when we're not paying for anything? So I thought, fuck it, I'm not going to pay for anything. That's a lot of balls, isn't it? So I recognised the fact that we're not paying, so I thought, well, I'm not going to pay because we're not paying. So, last thing to have a go at mortgages. So I asked them for a copy of the original contracts. Stop sending me mortgage statements, please. Send me a proper bill. And please show me where £160,000 transferred from your account to my account, and I'll carry on paying mortgage. Ignored me totally, went to court, almost got repossessed. I stopped it a few days before by backing down. I'm not ready for it yet. This back in 2011, I'm not ready for it. Okay. 2012, I go to court, I lose court case, I bow down, I have to become a slave, thinking I'll work on this mortgage and get on a later date, I'll regroup. Suspended possession order now, I've got some arrears. If I miss paying my mortgage or my arrears, the mortgage company can move straight to possession without a court case and just take me out and send bailiffs round. So that's where I'm at now, that's the position I'm in. Okay, just before last Christmas, 2012, I've been paying for 13 months, never missed a payment. 6 minutes and we'll call it a day. Never missed a payment in 13 months. I've got a suspended order and I'm trying to look at different, I've been studying it now for all year. Mortgage company, without me knowing, I've been paying the mortgage and some arrears, £130 a month off the arrears. I'm juggling a load of figures around without me knowing. 20th of December, I now realise they are going to come back at me every Christmas now. So this is 20th of December, get a letter, boom. You've not been paying your obligation, your arrears. They moved straight, sent a letter to court, the judge looked at it, boom, I'm out again. And the second week, this time I haven't done anything wrong, I've paid everything. I fill in an N244 form, I get an emergency court hearings when all that snow were on the ground. I've got to be out by January 23rd. I managed, because all the snow were happening all just after January, I managed to get an emergency court hearing when? 24 hours before. Fucking hell, how close is this? Last time it were 9 days, this time I've got an emergency court case 24 hours. If I don't get a decision, I'm out. This is 22nd, I'm out on 23rd. Inch Street, with kids, with bin liners. So this is what I mean, I've suffered a little bit, but I'm learning loads. I get an emergency hearing. I finally go to a little tiny county court, it's only good this big. I'm closed up now, 3 more minutes I've done. I keep saying that, don't I? I'm going to court. Remember, I've paid everything and they've juggled figures round. I go into court, I said to the judge, district judge in his chambers, I says, where's the other side? He says, they've backed out. I says, when? He says, they faxed me 20 minutes ago. So these horrible bastards, knowing I'm a single parent with kids and I paid, made me panic, which I didn't do, to create that fear that we're talking about all the way through Christmas, right up to 20 minutes before my court case, and then they faxed and back down right at last minute and withdrew the claim because they had no claim. Mm. So this is what I'm talking about, it's all about fear. That's what I was talking about at the start. I've got no fear, I was prepared to get kicked out. I'm not going to get kicked out anyway. You can never be repossessed out of your house. I think Rob B's going to talk a little bit about when Bailey's try and kick you out of your house and among other things, so I'll leave that for him to do. So, in conclusion, that's good enough for me. In conclusion, what I've decided to do is I'm not going to wait for next Christmas. I'm not going to wait. Oh, judge said to me, he said they didn't turn up. He said, he went, just a bloke in a suit, they were nice. I've had three district judges, they've all been all right, so there is some hope for them. He went, do you want to call Rob or Robert? I said, Rob. He went, wait, Robert. He says, can you afford it? I went, yeah. I says, you know, it's not easy. I says, but yeah, I'm not struggling, it's all right. He went, well, you've never missed a fucking payment, I didn't swear. He says, you've never missed a payment, have you? I went, no. He says, well, it looks like they've juggled figures to me. I says, that's exactly what they've done to get me out. He went, well, he says, I suggest you claim against them for doing that, how they've tricked you. So this is a district judge telling me what to do. So what I'm saying is they're going to come back at me every Christmas now or sooner, juggle figures, because I've asked for certain things, they know I'm onto them, that it's all fraudulent, they want me out. So, that's about folks, don't you? Not that I need it. So what I've decided to do is I've been working on those things that I asked for a mortgage. Is anybody aware of voidmortgage.com, I think it is? get on that site. If you haven't got a mortgage yourself, it's still interesting, and you must know somebody that has got a mortgage. Voidmortgage.com, I think it is. Has anybody heard of it?
Yeah.
Okay. Get yourself on that. There's the three things that I asked for makes it fraudulent. I'm putting a package together now, and hopefully, with the help of my good friend, Rob there, we are making a documentary about my journey with the mortgage people. I'm starting in 2 months. It's the last thing I've got to pay, and then I completely don't pay anything at all, nothing. I don't pay a thing, apart from a bit of food for kids. And that's about it. We're going to film it. I'm not going to wait for these mortgage people. So first part, it's in three sections. First section is those three things that I asked for, original contract box and all that. The second is what voidmortgage.com do. The deed is never signed. I'll go into this in detail another time. And there's a registration, what's called a registration gap, between when you sign the mortgage and when it's done electronically, which voids the whole thing. Plus the deed is never signed. Great website, have a look at it, voidmortgage.com. So I'm utilising the first section that I've come up with, the second section that they've come up with, and then 2 more minutes, I'll clear off. And I've utilised something I've found out, is that when I bought my house, this is the third section, so I'm going to shove it all together. I'll tell you this third section in a minute. I'm going to put it to mortgage company, give them 30 days. That's 30. I'm going to give them 30 days to respond. 30 days to respond. When they don't, I may give them another 2 weeks. And then after that, what I've decided is, and I'm sure Rob, I don't know if Rob is in here, he agrees with me. There is no civil remedy in the legal... in the legal system, as far as I'm aware now, and I proved it. What I'm going to be doing is filing criminal charges against these people. We've got to turn it back into a crime. I'm turning it into a private prosecution. Criminal charges, I've got a whole host of charges. Okay, two sections, I've got 1 minute left. The third section I've come up with is, I bought a house and it's called a freehold. It says it, freehold. I looked at what freehold really meant. I studied it. Freehold means it's held free from any claims, liens, which is another kind of claim, or encumbrances. Okay, you can't put... When I borrowed the money, which I didn't borrow, from the mortgage people, they placed a charge on my property, yeah? You can't place a charge on a freehold property. It's impossible. That's why it's called freehold. It's held free from any charges, claims, liens, encumbrances. Okay, that's my piece of land and the house is there in the garden. If you can't put a charge on that piece of property, how can they nearly get me out twice by me getting in arrears and the charge getting triggered? Okay, 25 Ash Street is my address. It's not, so don't all come round. I ain't got enough teakle. 25 Ash Street is my address, yeah? They've sent the charges on 25 Ash Street, which is this, yeah? Imagine that's my house and garden, and that's the street, yeah? That's Ash Street. What I realise is I don't live on Ash Street. I live at the side of fucking Ash Street. Ash Street goes straight past me. My freehold is not 25 Ash Street. Believe it or not, the only reason they can place a charge on 25 Ash Street is that is not Ash Street, it's my freehold property, I'm the freeholder. The charge they've got is a piece of land that makes up the street called an easement parcel of land. That's fucking 25 Ash Street. I can prove it, I've got my original documents to prove it. That piece of land is held in trust by the council. It's called an easement parcel of land, yeah? The charge that they're saying is triggered applies to the piece of land in front of my house. It makes up the street. That's the only fucking bit they can repossess, not my fucker. And I've got the documents to prove it, okay? So that's the whole package that I'm putting towards them. It's going to be documented. I don't know whether I'm going to win or lose, but I do know I'm going to win. And if I don't win, I'm going to tweak it. Basically, I'm going to finish up now. Thanks a lot for listening. I'm going to take these people. I'm going to try and be honourable. I'm going to carry on paying now, 30 days, a couple of weeks, but then I'm going to file criminal charges against them in a private prosecution. If this works, it's something we can all use, because every single mortgage, where the charge, any charge, council tax or anything, I can prove that your address is not where you live. It's the part that makes up the street. That's why gas, water and electric come across your easement, comes across that parcel of land. And I've got the original drawings to show it. So that's what I'm going to be working on now. It's going to be documented. It's going to be done really good as well, not just a little YouTube thing. And whatever happens, win or lose, and I know I'm going to win, it can set a precedent. Everything we're going to do now, file criminal charges, hold these fuckers accountable. And this is what I'm so proud of, you lot coming today, and all the speakers, and Paul and everybody else, is today for me, it's let's stop fucking about, let's stop fanning about, let's stop consenting, They're harming us, they're harming our kids, we know what the agenda is, to fucking get rid of us, let's turn it criminal, let's hold them accountable, there's no remedy in civil matter, let's turn it criminal, and expose them for the fucking criminals they are. So thanks a lot for listening.